Good morning. I'm on a central line heading out to West London, Zone 3, to do the end of the line at Ealing Broadway.
The next station is Ealing Broadway, where this train terminates.
Okay, so that's just me being fun by pointing out that Ealing Broadway is the end of the line for both the District, which I really arrived on, and the Central line. I think that's the first time you've had two underground lines terminate at a station for the end of the line. If you do come here, this is the immediate thing you have to do. If you come down to the end of these platforms, we'll discuss platforms later, but there's a, similar to High Barnet, there's a walk around section here to get you from platform 9 round to the other platforms, but it allows this brilliant look back along the District Line platforms there. I've got some photos from here from many years ago from an engineering weekend when they actually ran Piccadilly Line trains in on this platform. That is a fun photo to see because it's not often you get to see Pic Line stock at Ealing Broadway. But then whilst you're down here, down this end, you cannot but help but notice these old signs. Now there are five of them. And what I'm told by different conflicting reports is that either they're all fake, as in they're all replicas, or one of them, one out of the five, might be an original. But I don't know. So come and look at these gorgeous old signs, the old style roundels here at Ealing Broadway. But help me out, YouTube. Are they all real? Are they replicas? Is only one of them out of the five original and the other four replicas? Because I don't know. But do come and admire these signs. If you've not actually been to Ealing Broadway for a while and you think you know it from many years ago, then you might be in for a shock as to how it looks now. As since the Crossrail Elizabeth line started running through here, the station entrance has been completely rebuilt. It's now also operated by TfL and therefore it's got an extremely purple feel to it. That is so weird. Pre-Crossrail, pre-Elizabeth line, you used to come up the steps there and then just keep on going and walk through, and where this wall is, that was the gate line and the ticket barriers. I've now just turned into toilets, and the new ticket area is up here. Ealing Broadway is, as I always remember it though, very busy. It's a bustling and noisy end of the line with loads of people all about. And it's surprising, therefore, that it doesn't top the statistics for most busy end of the line station. Amongst all that busyness, though, is something quite cool that you can spot. It's very noisy, busy, buses, people, shops over there. There's a drill. The bane of the videographer's life is having to contend with the drill. But that's Ealing Broadway for you. It's a very busy area, which I kind of like. And if you let the buses pass, you can see this building here is the original Ealing Broadway station. 1838, I do believe. Remember when we was at Harrow the other day? I spoke about stations that had been in existence before the underground was created. Same here for Ealing Broadway. At the top, there's even a sign up there, which you might have missed if you've like lived here for years of your life, that says Ealing Broadway station, which is now a row of shops. One of the good things about the Elizabeth line Crossrail here at Ealing Broadway is that they've put lifts to all the platforms, so it is now perfectly and correctly step free, which is nice. I've never been in that lift before. Now back when TfL Rail first started running through here, and then consequently now of course Cross Liz Perp train started running through here, this seriously became a TfL and a TfL branded station. It has 9 platforms, 1 and 2, which are the fast GWR trains, 3 and 2 stopping trains, some stopping GWR and Liz Line trains, 5 and 6, and then Central Line, 7, 8, 9, and then the 3 platforms used by the District Line. But even the GWR platforms, where trains don't stop, and I've been recording this piece hoping for a train to come through, are in the TfL uppercase font. But 9 platforms is at the highest number of platforms we've had at an end of the line station so far. I think it might be. Oh, and also, if you're playing bingo, there's no Wimpy here. You can tick Wimpy off.
And there goes the fast train, but I'm just going to take a moment now to sit on this handy bench and check my online presence as we discuss this video's sponsor. So if you use the internet a lot like I do, you may be aware that there are companies on the web that collect your data, known as data brokers, and they then sell the data that they have about you on to others. Now you can go around to all the individual companies that you know of and ask them to remove your data, but there could be hundreds of them that you'd have to contact in different ways, and sometimes they might even refuse your request. So that's why there's one company that will do all the hard work for you and clean up all your digital data on the internet for you. And that's what today's sponsor, Incogni, does for you. Sign up with them, tell them to work on your behalf, and they will go ahead and do all the hard work for you. And you can log in and check to see who they've contacted and what progress has been made. And you'll start to be notified from companies that your data has been removed. And this could just be something simple where you've signed up for a newsletter or loyalty card, and yet your data is used to contact you about something else from somebody else that you might not even know. Incogni will clean all this up for you and make it go away. If you want to know more, it's worth looking at the promo here. Go to incogni.com/Jeff, and the first 100 people get 20% off, a great deal. There's a link down in the description below. Ealing Broadway also has Labyrinth number 21, and when I got this shot, I noted that next to it, Ealing Broadway now has a pink Oyster validator, because the Elizabeth line now brings in new connection options which weren't available before. This takes the total number of stations outside of Zone 1 with pink validators to 17. A quick admire of the canopy over the central line platforms, and then it was time to brave the outside world with the crowds again. Yes, the streets and shopping centres of Ealing Broadway were still there, but in the middle of it all, I managed to find a small oasis of calm in nearby Walpole Park. That's where you'll find Pitshanger Manor, which was once the residence of Sir John Soane, one of the most influential architects in British history. It's now a delightful art gallery, but it's not open every day, so do check the opening times.
And that is Ealing Broadway, a sleepy backwater with birds chirping in the trees and no passengers. It is not. If you want noise, if you want shops, if you want bustling busyness, do come to Ealing Broadway if you're exploring your own End of the Line series. On Twitter, by the way, every time I publish one of these videos, I put up a graphic. It's like the intro slide, but with the passenger numbers of all the ends of the line stations that I've been going around to. So I publish that on a regular basis. You can download it from my website as well. Thanks to Incogni for sponsoring this video. There's a title card coming up, and in that, in the corner, there'll be a playlist to all the videos in the End of the Line series. Press subscribe to my channel. Thank you if you haven't already done so. See you in the next video. Bye.